Hello, welcome to the Tuesday, December 8th, 2020 edition of the Sands and Storm Center's Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich, and today I'm recording from Jacksonville, Florida. Great and extensive follow-up today by Didier about a diary that he actually posted a while ago about corrupted Base64 strings, more details on detecting them, and also ultimately decoding them, even if they're not quite meeting the Base64 standard. Security researcher Oscars Vagaris did publish an interesting blog post regarding a recently patched vulnerability in Microsoft Teams. And now Oscar found originally this vulnerability, but is disputing the impact that Microsoft assigned to the vulnerability. No need to patch. Microsoft Teams patches itself automatically, but Microsoft only considered it as a spoofing vulnerability. Now, at the root, there was a cross-site scripting problem, and Oscars has found similar problems in Slack. Turns out that Microsoft Teams, just like Slack, is written using the Electron framework. Electron, I've mentioned it a couple times before in this podcast, is a framework that allows you to write desktop applications using JavaScript and HTML. So essentially, your desktop application is using the same code as a web application. That's at least the idea. But with that, of course, vulnerabilities are also kind of transferred, and a cross-site scripting vulnerability in an Electron application does often indicate that you may be able to execute arbitrary code, because this JavaScript that you're now injecting with your cross-site scripting exploit is not displayed by a browser, but instead interpreted by the Electron framework and treated as native code that runs on your system. To add insult to injury, in order to actually trigger this vulnerability, a victim doesn't actually have to click at anything or really interact. They just have to view a Teams message in the Teams application. So no real meaningful user interaction is required. Again, this was patched back in October, and Teams does sort of patch itself, so nothing really that you should have to apply necessarily here, but maybe double check and make sure that Microsoft Teams is actually up to date on your system. And if you are developing applications using the Electron framework, then do make sure that you are treating cross-site scripting vulnerabilities with the respect necessary. And well, apparently one Electron application vulnerability isn't enough. We do have a second one. The second one affects PlayStation Now. Now, this one's a little bit different. With PlayStation Now, you also have a WebSocket server that listens on localhost port 1235. But the PS Now Electron application, and that's called AGL, can be used to load code from arbitrary websites. And with that, well, we are back to injecting JavaScript that then is being executed. And as a result, we end up with good old remote code execution. Now, this one requires a tiny little bit of user interaction. A user has to visit a malicious website that at that point then can take over the process and execute arbitrary code. The researcher who found this vulnerability, Parsia Hakimian, did report this via the HackerOne bug bounty program and did actually make $15,000 off this vulnerability. And back in August, security researcher Florian Hauser did report 12 different vulnerabilities in Cisco's security manager to Cisco, and also provided proof of concept code. Now, these vulnerabilities can lead to unauthenticated remote code execution in this product that's often used to manage enterprise security policies. Now, Cisco did release two patches for two different CVE numbers back in October, I believe, or November, but only now delivered the remaining patch for the third CVE. So a total of 12 vulnerabilities were reported, but Cisco sort of grouped them together into these three CVEs, and this most recent patch does fix the remaining problems. And of course, given the impact, you want to make sure that you're updating your Cisco Security Manager to release 4.22 Service Pack 1. And that's it for today. So thanks again for listening, and talk to you again tomorrow.